highly regarded and respected.
One of the best coaches in the game.
He made pretty much everyone who played with him a better player.
I think the thing that really stands out to me is how he's not afraid to make a tough decision.
Players coach. I played for him. Players love playing for him.
He was that stern father figure that commanded respect.
He was a very demanding coach.
He's won at every level.
One of the greatest coaches that this game has ever known.
Welcome to NHL Network's countdown of the top 30 coaches of all time. I'm Jamie Hirsch. Success in the NHL is not solely determined on the skill of a team, but a combination of talent and leadership. While it takes a crew of craftsmen on the ice to win a championship, no dynasty has achieved greatness without the direction of a competent and proficient manager. From stoic coaches to impassioned personalities, we kick off our countdown at number 30 with a man called Gabby.
You look at the winning percentage that Bruce Boudreau has, known as a very good offensive coach, and in Washington, his team president's trophy and led the league in scoring.
That's when he scores!
And in Anaheim, same thing.
His team with his fourth consecutive Pacific Division title.
At the end of the day, he's just an honest coach. He's not one to bark for jam information down your throat, but at the same time, he does command that respect and he brings that swagger to the game.
Centerman Billy Ray spent 10 years playing in the NHL before taking up his post on the bench. In his first 2 years as a head coach, Ray led the blue and white in Toronto before beginning his 14-year tenure with the Chicago Blackhawks. Between 1963 and 1977, Ray's Blackhawks celebrated 6 first-place finishes. Ray coached in over 1,000 games and has a total of 599 wins to his credit.
He just had a natural presence about it. Once we were on the ice, he let us be ourselves. He didn't try to micromanage everything.
Daniel Alfredson sent the Ottawa Senators to the Stanley Cup Final for the first time in franchise history.
I always try to empower players. I always felt that if I allowed them to talk to me, they would listen when I talk to them. He is the best coach I've ever had.
Ron Wilson.
But his stock is going up.
Yes.
A little message for all of our fans. Don't get comfortable in your seats. My job coming in here is to make sure you spend more time on your feet.
Washington Capitals and Ole Kolzic celebrate back-to-back Southeast Division championships.
Took the Capitals to a couple division titles and pushed the Stanley Cup Finals.
They score! Capitals are headed to the Stanley Cup Final!
Alain Vigneault, the master at matching the lines and getting who he wants out. We've seen how many games he won.
Win number 600 for head coach Alain Vigneault.
And how consistent he has been.
The Jack Adams Award goes to Alain Vigneault.
Vancouver Canucks to the Stanley Cup Finals for the third time in their history. The Rangers are going to the final.
What a career he's had as a coach, continually learning, and he's done a marvelous job.
Lindy Ruff wins his first game as head coach. The Buffalo Sabres are your Eastern Conference champions.
One of only 4 people in the history of the NHL to have coached in over 1,300 games and played in over 600 games.
The Dallas Stars come into Los Angeles, down a goal going into the third, and come back and win it.
And they win number 700 for Lindy Ruff.
I'm looking forward to the next 700.
There's Barry Trotz. One of the good guys in the game.
When he started with the expansion Predators in 98, his only goal was to get through the season.
After spending 15 years with the Nashville Predators, this is his second year in Washington.
And he has made a huge difference in this Caps team.
Great teams are a little harder to coach, aren't they? The teams that nothing is expected of.
You won't see Barry Trotz get very animated, very quiet and calm behind that bench. But wow, one of the great coaches in the NHL.
Take a look at John Tortorella. He's an intense individual. Tortorella, not always that calm.
John Tortorella has gone over to the Calgary Flames hallway.
If you're not going to play the right way, you're not going to play.
John Tortorella, Quinn's leader among U.S.-born head coaches. One of only 5 U.S.-born coaches to ever win the Stanley Cup.
I can't stand losing. Everybody says be a good loser. I think if you're a good loser, you're a loser.
Claude Julien, all class.
Good man, even better coach.
Victory number 400 behind the Bruins bench for Claude Julien. A milestone moment for the winningest coach in Bruins history.
Claude Julien is the new head coach of the Montreal Canadiens. Claude Julien is back in Montreal.
And if there were any doubters about his coaching ability, there certainly are not any now.
Lester Silver Fox Patrick was an instrumental figure for the New York Rangers during the early 20th century. Between 1926 and 1939, Lester's Rangers captured two of the club's four Stanley Cup championships. In 1947, Lester was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame. And in 1966, the NHL began presenting an award in his name to honor those for their contribution to hockey in the United States. Still to come, we continue counting down the top 30 coaches of all time, featuring a man immortalized in a trophy. Where will this top coach fall on our countdown?
And the Jack Adams Award goes to?
Find out next. Welcome back to the top 30 coaches of all time. The Detroit Red Wings of the 1950s boasted some of the greatest players to ever hit the ice. With future Hall of Famers like Ted Lindsay, Gordie Howe, and Terry Sawchuk, it is no surprise that the Red Wings reigned supreme four times between 1950 and 1955. Let's jump back into our countdown at number 20 with the man that guided these historic teams. Although he never played in the NHL, Tommy Ivan cemented his legacy in hockey history as a coach for the Detroit Red Wings during the 1950s. Under his command, the Red Wings finished in first place six consecutive years with a roster full of remarkable talent and legends in the making. Ivan led his Red Wings to three Stanley Cup championships between 1950 and 1954. The only man to have his name on a Stanley Cup as a player, coach, and general manager, Jack Adams had a storied NHL career. As a coach, Adams began his career in 1927 in Detroit and held that title for 20 years. Adams celebrated three Stanley Cup championships with the Red Wings. Due to his success on the bench, the NHL honored Adams with a trophy in his name, which is given to the top coach each year. Mike Keenan began his coaching career in 1984 with the Philadelphia Flyers. In his first 3 years in Philly, Keenan's Flyers were Prince of Wales Conference champions twice. After 4 years in the city of brotherly love, Keenan spent time in Chicago before a short stint in New York with the Rangers. Although Keenan only lasted one season in the Big Apple, it was a memorable year as he led the Rangers to their first Stanley Cup championship since 1940. After enjoying a playing career as an accomplished defenseman, Art Ross embarked on a coaching career in 1917. Between 1924 and 1945, Ross captained the Boston Bruins to seven first-place finishes and two Stanley Cup championships. Ross was inducted as a player into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 1949.
Brady was ahead of his time in a lot of ways, studying video, instilling a system that would give you an opportunity to win, playing the right players at the right time for the right reasons.
He was a glue. He was perfect for our mentality, our behavior.
It's all over! The Flyers have won the second in a row!
He was a fog, but also a very astute legend out there. Whatever he said, we believed was gospel, and we would do anything for him. We went out, and he's a great guy to follow as a leader.
Clarence Hap Day was called upon by Conn Smythe in 1940 to take over as head coach for the Maple Leafs when Dick Irvin left for Montreal. For the next 10 years in Toronto, Day was considered the most successful head coach in the league. His Maple Leafs were crowned Stanley Cup champs five times from 1941 to 1949. Hap was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 1961.
Daryl Sutter has done a marvelous job with the LA Kings.
He doesn't like to be in the limelight as far as thinking himself as a star, but those numbers tell the story for Daryl Sutter.
With Sutter getting 200 wins as a King coach, he is 15 away to lead the Kings.
A big part of the reason why they were able to get Stanley Cups. And boy, you talk about a guy that's demanding and wants the game to be played a certain way. That man does.
The Hockey Hall of Fame is pleased to welcome as a builder inductee
Pat Quinn.
Hold your spots here, guys. We're running after that puck a little bit too much.
A player's coach. I played for him. Players love playing for him.
He's brought forth to us a new dimension to the game.
Time with Philadelphia, Los Angeles, Vancouver, Toronto, briefly with Edmonton, led two teams to a cup final.
I like the challenges. You come to work every day with a new challenge. That's the spirit of life that I like.
Coming up next, our countdown rolls on with a coaching duo in Edmonton. Find out where this twice as nice team ranks after the break. Welcome back to the top 30 coaches of all time. As a player, Jacques Lemaire spent his entire 12-year career in Montreal with the Canadiens. Between 1968 and 1979, Lemaire and the Habs won an astounding 8 championships. Lemaire was a key factor during those championship years, scoring 11 goals during the playoffs, including the overtime winner during the 1977 Stanley Cup Final. Time now to dive right back into our countdown with this French phenom at number 12.
Our focus on opening night to a successful, familiar old face to the sport, but a brand new face to coaching in New Jersey. Hockey Hall of Famer, Jacques Lemaire.
Jacques preaches defense first. He wants all five guys playing on the same system and playing, you know, together. And Jacques' philosophy, which obviously has worked over his career, is if you only allow the team one or two goals against tonight, you have a chance every night.
The Devils are going to try to trap and counter to get their offense. Detroit says we're going to beat you with speed. Let's see if they can trap the Red Wings.
The championship to New Jersey. The Devils win the Stanley Cup.
I told them that if you ever win it, and you'll be on top of the world. As soon as they present the cup, a couple guys came to see me and said, it's true, we're on top of the world.
Highly regarded and respected.
Well, Mike Babcock is one of the best coaches in the game.
Started the course with the Ducks and ended up with an unbelievable career with the Detroit Red Wings, now trying to rebuild the Toronto Maple Leafs. Coaching in his 1,000th game.
Mike Babcock, tremendous records, demanding, but know how to get the most out of every player.
3 Stanley Cup finals, 1 win, a world championship, gold medals at the Olympics, world juniors. He has won at every level.
Roger Nielsen's coaching career, which began in 1977, spanned over 4 decades and 8 different teams. Nielsen's one and only Stanley Cup final appearance came in 1982 with the Vancouver Canucks. Following his success in Vancouver, Nielsen went on to coach the New York Rangers from 1989 to 1993. During his 3rd year in New York, Nielsen's Rangers won the President's Trophy. In that same year, Nielsen was runner-up for the Jack Adams Award. Nielsen was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 2002.
You know, a lot of people think that the Canadians took a guy out of a police car and put him behind a Montreal Canadian bench. I'm not ashamed to say I was a policeman, very proud of it. But now it's over and I'm in something else and I want to just turn the page.
Pat Burns says good people, not just good players, find a way of winning in any competitive environment.
The New Jersey Devils are the 2003 Stanley Cup champions.
And the players are hugging each other, they're hugging the coach. Even Pat Burns looks like he's getting emotional down there.
Well, everybody's entitled to their opinion. I don't agree with them naturally. I think that Toronto's going to win the Stanley Cup. We can beat them all without any trouble, too.
He was a very demanding coach in that league, you know, and you do what I tell you to do, and he says, you'll be here a long time, and we were together a long time for about 10 years winning 4 cups.
Well, we didn't win it for the Toronto Raiders. We won it for the Toronto fans.
Well, Ken Hitchcock is fast approaching Al Arbour as the 3rd winningest coach in the history of this game.
Hitch is 2nd in the Jackets' all-time win list. All-time games played, he is number 1.
Like, he's had some nice moments standing exactly where he is standing right now when he was with the Dallas Stars.
They went on to win the 1999 the Stanley Cup.
He did so much for this organization in 6 years here at Series.
Got that serious look on his face.
He's always serious, Jeff.
You can have a team full of great players, but that's not going to equate into a Stanley Cup championship.
You have to treat everybody as an individual, treat them as they're the most important person in the world, and all these players were very important to me.
The Oilers have won John Muckler, the associate Oiler coach, will he be a head coach with some other team in the National League next year? I think not.
The Edmonton Oilers, Stanley Cup champions 1990. The players on the ice celebrating. On the Oilers bench, they're celebrating. And the crowd is now standing. And they, too, salute the Edmonton Oilers.
Coming up next, our countdown wraps up with the top five coaches of all time who have a combined 28 Stanley Cup championships between them. Where will these legendary leaders rank on our countdown? Stick around to find out. Welcome back to the top 30 coaches of all time. Let's take a look back at the men that have made our list so far.
At the end of the day, he's just an honest coach, and he brings that swagger to the game.
Ray coached in over 1,000 games.
He just had a natural presence about it. Once we were on the ice, he let us be ourselves.
My job coming in here is to make sure you spend more time on your feet.
What a career he's had as a coach, continually learning.
And they win number 700 for Lindy Ruff.
And there's Barry Trotz, one of the good guys in the game.
I can't stand losing. Everybody says be a good loser. I think if you're a good loser, you're a loser.
Claude Julien, all class.
Good man, even better coach.
The NHL began presenting an award in his name. Ivan led his Red Wings to 3 Stanley Cup championships. The only man to have his name on a Stanley Cup as a player, coach, and general manager. Mike Keenan began his coaching career in 1984. Art Ross embarked on a coaching career in 1917.
Whatever he said, we believe was gospel, and we would do anything for him. He was a great guy to follow.
His Maple Leafs were crowned Stanley Cup champs 5 times.
You talk about a guy that's demanding and wants the game to be played a certain way.
A player's coach. I played for him. Players love playing for him.
He led 2 teams to a cup final.
Jacques preaches defense first. He wants all 5 guys playing, together.
3 Stanley Cup finals, gold medals at the Olympics. He is won at every level.
Nielsen's Rangers won the President's Trophy.
Pat Burns says good players find a way of winning in any competitive environment.
He was a very demanding coach in that league.
He's always serious, Jeff.
You can have a team full of great players, but that's not going to equate into a Stanley Cup championship.
Let's wrap up our countdown with the top 5 coaches of all time. Although he was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame as a player, Dick Ervin was one of the greatest coaches the game has ever known. From 1931 to 1940, Ervin was the man behind the blue and white. In his first season in Toronto, Ervin led the Maple Leafs to their first championship in 10 years. Ervin's greatest success as a coach came in 1940 when he left Toronto for Montreal. For the next 16 years, Ervin led the Habs to 3 Stanley Cups and coached in 1,449 regular season games.
Joe Quennville became the 11th coach in NHL history to win 3 Stanley Cups.
Joel Quennville has many qualities as a coach, but from afar, I think the thing that really stands out to me is how he's not afraid to make a tough decision.
He was great. He's a real player's coach. He's good at managing the team.
He's given me every opportunity I could ask for, and he respects his players, and players respect him, and he's one of those coaches that gets the best out of all of his players. I think that's why he's been so successful.
Not only entertaining at times on the bench, but wants to win more than anybody.
And Joel Quenneville, now the 2nd all-time winningest coach in NHL history.
I feel very fortunate and honored to be in some great company. And the one thing that I've always been fortunate, we've always had good teams, and that certainly helps.
I think they respect that guy. They play hard for that guy.
I won't make any predictions. We'll play the best we can. Anyway, predictions are for gypsies.
He was tough, he had savvy.
3 Stanley Cups in 3 years, Toe Blake, a Montreal Canadiens.
He just had a very good, hard style.
And Toe Blake realizes that is it. But come what may, that he has done just a magnificent job.
Coach Toe Blake had a strong bench to go with his all-stars. Young Don Marshall on the left, and on the right, Al McDonald. Just up from St. Catharines, PB.
And he made pretty much everyone who played with him a better player.
The winning coach is hoisted high on his players' shoulders. The forum rocks with the noise.
Joe Blake said this was the best hockey club he ever saw, sweeping as it did the semifinal and finals in the minimum 8 games, and reaching the pedestal of 5 straight Stanley Cups.
As a coach, he is the only man to guide an expansion team to 4 consecutive Stanley Cups.
me, he was that stern father figure that commanded respect.
I have a teaching style that's probably a little different than probably a lot of other coaches. I watch the videotapes an awful lot. I have a way of teaching players that I believe in, and I spend a lot of time trying to get the point across.
He was tough, but fair. Al, the way I say it was, when you thought you might get a pat on the back, you might kick in the butt, you know, and it was the opposite too. So he kept you off balance in that regard.
And Al Arbour, one of the greatest coaches that this game has ever known.
And the New York Islanders have won their fourth great Stanley Cup.
Words can't fully describe how I really feel here tonight. To be included in the hall with so many of my heroes, like my kids say, it's awesome, Dad. And it really is.
He won five Stanley Cups here in Montreal, is the most decorated coach in NHL history with nine cups in all. Ladies and gentlemen, the incomparable Scotty Bowman.
You had the puck here, Donnie. Keep it. Do anything but what you did. You threw the puck all the way around. Now, it could hit somebody here and come out in front with a second to go and it's in the net.
Sam Pollock was the general manager in Montreal. He was quite a baseball enthusiast, and he once told me, he said, I can take a lot of aggravation from a 300 hitter, none from a 200 hitter. I kind of use that as a way to try to coach.
What I like about Scotty is when I hear guys talk about him that he coached in the past, they say great things about him. Maybe didn't feel that at the time, but certainly feel that now.
Changed me as a hockey player, and in a lot of ways, made me a much better leader, much better captain, and I think a lot better person as well. So once again, I'm forever grateful to Scotty and his efforts as a coach.
There it is, the top 30 coaches of all time. Coaching in the NHL requires one to wear many hats. Whether it means being a mentor, a friend, or a strict enforcer, the great coaches of the game know how to balance each of these roles to get the best out of their players. For NHL Network, I'm Jamie Hirsch. We'll see you next time.